This is okay, porn. Oh, it's slowing us down now, boss. All right, delete on close. Let's see if a little bit of a retrograde burn, what that does. Wow, that's not what we want at all. It did take it down. Looks like we need to burn in this direction, I think. This would be radial out. Nope, opposite of that. My bad. Screet. All right, here we go. Ooh. I can't. I'm going to have to get, like, almost in here. Maybe we just need to enter the sphere of influence and set a node right here. Let's just set it at the sphere of influence change. I'm just wasting fuel. I mean, wasting 0.0 meters per second, right? But that's okay. Let's just get out here. This is another 420 days. And we are on an impact course for Elu right now. Let's see what we got. It's like I'm leveling up or something. Oh, Elu is gonna run into us from behind. We should make a Lilu impactor. We should have brought a soda can or a tab or something. Nice! Welcome back, Sleepy. We are trying to get to Elu. With a Dr. Pepper can. Did you see that? You know we're flying a single Dr. Pepper can. Ah, there went those stupid batteries again. That's okay. We put it in sleep mode just like Rosetta. If I ever forget one of those things, I'm gonna be boned, yo. Still 150 days out with an Elu impact course. And we're just gonna tweak that last 5,000 feet inside the Elu's sphere of influence. Aw, Chase, I am flying a very small probe consisting of a Dr. Pepper can with an engine and a probe core on it, solar panels and stuff, to do a flyby of Elu. Elu's the farthest out planet. It's like the Pluto, right? But that's the orbit of Elu, way the heck out there. We're meeting it here. Here we come. All right, slow me down now. 1,000. 1,000. And so we're just trying to do a very close flyby of Elu, and we're going to see how many planets we can go to using the Delta V in this Dr. Pepper can. Definitely for the Grand Tour. Nice. There you have it. No worries, Achase. Thanks for joining us. So now I need to go through the sphere of influence. Alright, now we're in Elu's sphere of influence. We don't want to slingshot off in that direction, it doesn't look like. Because our resulting course is going to be way outside the ecliptic. Not terribly, really. Alright. We're coming in low. That's basically all we have. Alright. So let's put a node here. Don't do me that way. Does anybody know how to fix that? When you can't put a freaking maneuver node? Oh, I can put one up there, apparently. No. Why can't I pull that node this way? Oh, there was one. See, it's like so confused, it has no clue. Oh, there I had one for a second. Up, oh, there I had it. Let's look along the orbit. There we go. Whatever, good enough. That's in 2 hours. How fast are we going to go hurtling by Elu? Alright, now what do we need to do? Yes, that is what we wanted. 106 meter periaps. What? 3,000 meter periaps. That's gonna be freaking low. Let's try a 3,000 meter periaps. And we will see. You can pass 20 meters. Use precise note to move. Yeah, you got it. Jump. Da 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 da. Jump. All right. Let's burn this node here. Probe's dead in the water. But that's okay. I've got the backup battery. It's interesting that the light on the battery doesn't go out. There we go. And activate. And where's the sun? Wow, the sun's a long ways away. Look how small the sun is. It's Kerbal. Alright, let's let that tank up right quick. While we turn off our emergency battery. Thank goodness for that emergency battery. I'm not gonna lie. And actually, it looks like our burn is going to be there with the sun as well. So let's see here. I think we can just do the burn right now. 0.3 meters per second. Is 4,000 meters good? DOS, it's carbonated powered, right? Yeah. If I'm using a command module with three pilots, does that mean you can take three surface samples? You only do one pilot. You can take three surface samples with one pilot. Sword. You should be good. Yeah, you got it. Softcore's got you there. Alright, this is all of the gravity assist we can get. And we're going to end up in an orbit looking like that. Going back down. Jules in front of us. But we are going... Which way are we going? Are we falling down? We're falling down right now. And so orbiting like that... Jewel is in front of us. We're not going to get a Jewel encounter from that. We're pretty darn close. Look at this, guys. Is that Kerbin again? That is Kerbin again. I wonder how much Delta V it would cost us to get up to Duna after this. I really want to get to Jewel. But we're passing it in that direction, so are we going to our... What's the time? What's next? Time to Apoaps or time to Periaps? Oh, it's not going to tell me. Great. Shucks. Tell me relative to there. Could I burn normal? I'm coming in from below the planet. So I could probably burn a little bit normal. Let's see. I really need enhanced nav ball. Here, we just do this. Add maneuver. I don't think it's going to change it. That's actually making it worse, it looks like. Yeah, we would need to burn anti-normal, it looks like. And that's going to give us a little bit better inclination. I mean, to flatten out all the way is a buck 17. Maybe we don't need to worry about that, I don't think. Oh, well, the node's past that. No wonder. What the heck? Why did the node turn like that? Alright, precise node. Cancel out all that normal burn. Put it back to zero. Okay, now I got the node where I want it. And now let's try to burn normal. It was the other direction because I had it after the node. We could... That's 27, and 27 gets us pretty darn close. So let's do that. What's our new periaps? 33? Ugh. So how can I do that and get a lower... That's pulling us up, apparently. 269. And then let's go down a little bit. Alright, so we've got to burn those two different things. Like, that's pretty close to the ecliptic, right there. I mean, we're not on its descending node right now, but we'll burn that. We'll burn that 22.7 in 2 hours. What? All right. Let's just get up there and let's get this done. I know I could use less Delta V right now, but whatever. 2 days, actually. Jeez. We're going to take too long planning nodes. Dang it. I've already done the flyby. Alarms for everything. I need a policy that's alarms for everything. No matter what. How are we doing now? I have a node coming up. I'm already in the sphere of influence. Okay, I saved it at a good time. Alright, we're good. How far out is this node? 2 hours. Okay, that's better anyways. Dough, right? I can't focus on that if I'm outside the Moonminster Dress, Lathe, Val, Tylobop, Pole, Elu. Oh, and now I'm back to my ship. Jewel, Lathe, Val, Tylopole, Bop, Elu. Okay. It's like I'm learning my planets. Alright. And we need to burn a little bit normal, you said, right? Why am I upside down? And that should flatten me out a bit. Yeah, that looks pretty darn good. Ooh, that actually messes me up down on that end. That'll be okay. Whatever. Alright, so let's do this burn. Jeez. Watch, my solar panels are dead. Yeah, look at our solar panels are dying, by the way. There was the node. Alright, we're also getting that. We can actually just burn right now, and we're focused on Elu. This is one of those burns where your trajectory is not changing very much, so it doesn't matter. $3,000? F5 for safety at $3,000? That is a pretty darned close encounter, y'all. Look at that, there's barely any starlight between those two things. Jeez. What is all this? Gosh. Alright, let us make sure that I'm straight at the sun. Where's the sun? There it is. Nope, up. Let's charge up them batteries, you. Alright, we're good to go. Emergency battery set. Now we just need to do the flyby. So I'm actually going to set an alarm right here. Then we can delete the node. We don't really care about having the node. It's just a good way to set an alarm when you're approaching someplace. Does anybody even know which way Elu is going to come from? I don't even know how to find it. I still don't see it. There it is. Alright, there's Elu. Crash landing confirmed. Nice. Whew, alright. Hopefully we're not going to hit any... Hopefully we're in F5 now. Yeah, I did. I did F5 for safety. Thank you, Chalkhouse, for watching my back. I am plugged in. We still have half a fuel tank left. And to circularize around Elu... Brown down, right? Wait, what? Huh? I'm just gonna play for a second here. Is there anything that we can do that's gonna get us any sort of encounter with another planet? Nope, Duna's on the wrong side of its orbit. That's not going to help us. What if we burn prograde? What if we burn prograde? Can we get anywhere else? Where is Jewel going to be? Something in the inner system, maybe? That'd be awesome if we could swing to the inner system and then come back out to the outer system. Let's look at where Eve is going to be. Because it's got such a small... Because maybe we could like do a gravity assist off Elu here. But honestly, it would be more efficient to burn out there, wouldn't it? I can't even click on the freaking node, yo. It's going to be more efficient to burn at ApoApps than it is going to be to burn here, isn't it? Wow, look at that! I wonder if we could get an Eve encounter. And then use Eve to slingshot back out to, oh, brown down. I thought you were talking about my, what? Yes, brown is down. In app notifications, huh? Okay, but that's for 352, right? And if we burn out here at the Apo apps, we can get that even counter for, well, interesting. 324. That is not as efficient, honestly. Huh. I guess the gravity slingshot makes up for the rest of it. What about Kerbin? Can we go back and slingshot off Kerbin? Nope, we're not gonna have a Kerbin encounter on the way back. Let's try Moho. No, that's Duna. Let's try Moho. We gotta get in closer before we even get Moho to res. There's Moho. Set his target. Moho has so many freaking launch windows. But I have a feeling to lower that encounter that much is gonna be a lot of our Delta V. Yeah, it's gonna be on the wrong side of its orbit. Dang it. Alright, so we didn't really find anything too great. Let's check address. I'm just checking things here. See if there's any sort of burn that we can do that will give us any sort of interesting action. Now, Dres is going to be on the other side of its orbit too. Dang it. Dres is completely uninteresting. Alright, last thing, let's check Jewel. So right now I don't even have a Jewel encounter. I'm apparently crossing underneath it. Alright, so let's there is where Jewel is gonna be next time we come around. Uh-oh. This is too much though. We need an inner planet to slingshot off of. Yeah, that ain't gonna work. Alright, we don't really have anything that we can do. We'll check it periaps. We will totally check it periaps. We're not gonna do anything. That AP burn is in 6 years. Oh, that's on the bottom of it? So, hey, we're coming up to, I see what you're saying. I didn't even bother to check. I was just playing around. What's our descending node? Negative 2.8. This is in 2 years. Aha! Thank you for looking out for me. I appreciate people who look out for me. So let's see if we slow down in 6 years. This is a very inefficient burn, isn't it? That's where Jewel's going to be in 6 years. On the opposite side of the solar system. So no bueno. We're coming on home right now. This is why they invented math. Alright, is there anything we can do here? That's Jewel. Duna? Set Duna as a target, maybe? No, Duna's gonna be where? Not the right place. There's a descending node we're about to cross on Duna. Nope, no bueno. Does anybody see anything that looks? The Atraxi. That's awesome. That's not going to do anything for us. What if we burn right when we come out? Oh, look at that entry, actually. Ding! It's going to be in the opposite side of its orbit when we get down there. Alright, let's try Eve on this side. Thank you for catching that, by the way. Well, a Kerbin... Yeah, that's... I could try a Kerbin encounter, too. No, less Delta V. Ooh, that's pretty darn close. I think Eve may be our best bet. Where is that us? Yes. We need to waste more time out here. Dang it, we would have had to... Let me put that back down to zero. Burn right after we leave here. What can I do to waste time? Or let me try for the Kerbin encounter. Let me see if we've got a Kerbin encounter. Kerbin's going to be coming around at us too. So if we could loiter some. We could get a Kerbin encounter. I could get a Kerbin encounter out of that. It would be a 500 or 600 Delta V. But I can definitely get a Kerbin encounter. Yeah, look at that. See? Oh, that's already on the other side, so we need to get there sooner now. Yeah, I mean, that's going to be 500 or 600 Delta V. Look at that. That's a Kerbin encounter right there if we do a mid-course plane correction. Should we go slingshot off Kerbin? It's too much Delta V to spend, you think? What do we have? What do we have to budget with? We have 4,000 Delta V. You think 5,000 for a Kerbin encounter might be too much to spend? Let me actually turn this into an encounter and see what we can do, what we can volley off of it. Alright, that's getting us further apart. That's getting us closer. There was a Kerbin encounter. And then once we're in the Kerbin system, let's see what we can do. This is like... Alright, there's Kerbin. So we would not want to come in south of Kerbin like that. We would want to come in north of Kerbin. Why do I have a purple node? That's interesting. There shouldn't be a node on the purple line. That was my Kerbin encounter node. What the deuce is this? Okay, how did I get two nodes? That's interesting. Anyways. Bing! There's a Kerbin encounter. Wait. Yeah, that's Kerbin. I'm zoomed way into the solar system. Where could I slingshot to? Off Kerbin itself, right? Alright, we would come clocking through the freaking Kerbin system. Come to the Stream of the Toss where we play interplanetary. Nice. Let's see here. What if we... Oh, look at this. Thwang! That will slingshot us to somewhere. What is this? That's the sun periapsis. And the Kerbin periapsis. Why do we have so many sun periapsises? Periapsisize. What if we just go for like the most hardcore swinging maneuver we can? Like this sort of deal. What was that? Oh, we started hitting Kerbin apparently. No. I'm still coming in low. Alright, we don't want to come in low. Now I'm not coming in low. There we go. Alright, now... Alright, that's what I want. That's exactly what I want. We do a Mooner flyby and there's like 18 different things. $178. Oh no, we don't want to hit Kerbin. We could definitely return home for 500 meters per second. How about that? We could arrow capture around Kerbin. Eek. No, I hate the scroll wheel. Why did they make it do that? Just keep it to fine increments. Now I've completely lost the freaking encounter. Oh my gosh, I hate the scroll wheel. What did I do? Did I scroll on the wrong freaking part? There we go. The scroll wheel is freaking terrible. How's it going? Thanks for the follow. I'm definitely concentrating here, sorry. Simply AF, how's it going? I'm concentrating a lot here. I do apologize. Okay, there we're hitting Kerbin. That's cool. Now we're going Kerbin around that way. Thwing! 78. Kerbin periaps is 78. Then we're just going to go off into that orbit. But is that going to get us any cool encounters anywhere? I don't think it is. Is it? DOS raid? Muddy raid? Oh, is this what's going on here? Is this a Muddy Unders raid? What? That's why all of these started coming off all of a sudden? Dude. Oh my gosh, I'm totally freaking muddy. Dude, you freaking rolling deep tonight, man. DOS Valdez at Muddy Dose. Dude. Yeah, when it starts going off like that, good night, Irene. We're trying to play orbital pinball here. Look at all the double raid, the muddy and the doze raid. Dude, you guys are nuts. Double raid is real. You guys are awesome. That is a lot of freaking follows. DOS raid is DOS. Wow. Yeah, I definitely need, I was like focusing on this planetary pinball thing. Nice, thank you, by the way. Congrats on 700. You guys are awesome. Muddy Unders and Doze. Where's old Doze at? Has Doze posted in chat? Doze. I don't see Doze anywhere. There we go, Mike Doze. With the follow. Thank you, sir. I should have done on this screen, because you could save me clicking follow. Both you guys, thanks for coming over. What a... Show my vehicle. So we're going interplanetary. You guys are here just in time, honestly. You know something? Let's stop playing around with these orbits and let's do the ELU flyby. Let's totally do the ELU flyby. And I will catch everybody with the follows there. Let me hit backspace to get in my craft. Let's get this ELU flyby done. Let's make it a real thing. Nope, not that. Come on. Ah, give me a place to put a node. There we go. Add maneuver. Kill that alarm. Add that alarm. Done. All right, let's do this ELU flyby. Do I have battery juice? Yes, I do. That's an interesting node. So we're just... We've got a Dr. Pepper can here. That has engines and solar panels and stuff on it. We actually launched a six-pack. And we've got this Dr. Pepper can going out to the farthest planet in the Kerbal system. ELU. This is like the Pluto. The Pluto analog. And we're about to do a very low flyby of ELU. 3,000 meters. So you guys got here just in time. Is my ass pointing towards the sun? Yes. I have to point the end towards the sun or else I run out of electric charge. So. And we have transcoders. Nice. Dude. I'm totally going to give that to the raid. The raid freaking brought the transcoders over. You guys are freaking awesome. I'm going to get the follows. Let's do the flyby here. Let me turn off the alarm clock. Let's go ahead and just fast forward up to ELU. There's ELU. I'm time warping. All right, and we're going to go by ELU at, what, 2 kilometers a second? So we're going to be flying by ELU at something like the dark side of ELU, apparently. That should be interesting. I hope I don't hit it. Did I have five? I better just load to the last save. I better just load to the last save. Floating points, no! Here we go. We're going to go on the dark side of ELU for a second. Look at this. Is it going to slow down my time warp? Wow. Are we gonna hit ELU? I think we may hit ELU, y'all. That may be a problem. Look at Dr. Pepper. So the entire point of flying the Dr. Pepper can out to ELU was to get it nice and cold. ELU is an ice planet, being the joke. Does it even have a texture on the ground? That ground is coming up hot. We need to see what our minimum surface altitude is. 4,000. Oh my goodness, is that a mountain? Tell me that's not a mountain. We're dropping fast. 3,000, 2,000, 27, 26. We're still going negative. 22. It looks like we're going over. Look at this mountain, though. This is going to be a problem. Print screen. Oh, my goodness. 1765678. I saw it go down to 15. And that is our Elu encounter. There ain't nothing going on out here. Why would anybody go to Elu? Go up! I'm good. We made it. We lived. We totally lived. Don't hit Elu. Dr. Pepper. Dude. You can get the Dr. Pepper can. It's a mod. You can install your own mod Dr. Pepper can. Got a nice scoop of ice. I think our Dr. Pepper can is nice and nice and cozy now. Nice and frosty. Now that we have done the flyby of Elu. Let's bid Elu adieu. Goodbye, Elu. Let's actually get a screenshot of this action. Goodbye, Elu. Print screen. There you go. That one had no atmosphere or anything. Why did we go to Elu? There's nothing going on at Elu. Let's get out of Elu's sphere of influence. Time to make a PBR beer lander. Instead of an explosion, it's a burst of 23 flavors. What was it? It was 24 flavors. It's 24 flavors. The 24th flavor is space. Go up. We totally... Thader! You were a little bit concerned there. Elu's tiny. We got almost no gravity slingshot from it. Look at this. Now we're leaving the sphere of influence. Look at the big ice cracks on it, right? There you go. That's a good screenshot right there. Maybe one up here like this. Passing Elu. So we were going to see what we could do next. Let me just get out of the sphere of influence. I don't want to plan inside the sphere of influence. Later, Elu! We should have watched it in the rearview mirror. It's gone already. I don't even know. I can't even find it in the sky anymore. It is totally gone. Alright, let's get out of the sphere of influence here. Dude, Muddy Unders, was that a host that I just saw? Did I see a host? Dude. Look up the button for Delta V. Nice, Aches. Oh, what did I miss? Yeah, Sleepy, you did come up with that. The 24th flavor is space. Was 1 kilometer below safe. Living on the danger side. Living in the danger zone. Dude, where is Muddy Unders? Dude, Muddy, you're freaking awesome. You brought all these freaking people. So many freaking people. What did we go to? We got the combo breaker. Let's see. I got to get all the follows. Everybody that followed. I got to do that. So what did we get? We got... Gosh. All in the same minute. Back Bowser, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Mike Doze, Nolex, Delta Wing Duck. Delta Wing Duck, that's cool. Fire Zones, 205, actually. Truthfoot, Pope Carl III, Simply AF, Aw Chase. Everybody that did the follows, thank you so much for the raid. Thank you so much for the follows. Mike Doze is hosting me too? Are you freaking kidding me? You're freaking kidding me. Dude, both of y'all with the host. You guys are freaking awesome. You guys are absolutely awesome. You guys are so freaking cool. Thank you so much. I am definitely going to share the love next time. I am definitely going to share the love. In fact, we're trying to see if we can get another encounter. Another encounter. We're coming down the orbit. We're coming down the orbit. Mr. Shadow is also with the follow. Thank you, sir. I do appreciate that. Let me see. Where is my... There we go. How are we doing? You guys are so freaking cool. There went another one. What was that one? Cold kills. Are those just coming in or did I already have those? Oh my gosh, guys. With the raid, we passed the official channel. With the raid coming in, we passed the official Kerbal Space Program channel. Which is freaking awesome. There's cold kill. I think I got you. 78. That's so freaking cool. You guys rock. Let me do something with this craft. I feel like I need to crash into this. Or do I need to do some sort of arrow capture. What if we just go back home? Because I don't think Jewel is in our... Jewel is not in our picture anywhere. What if we... I can do the orbit thing, right? By putting a node here. A node there. That's in 7 years. What if we wait? What if we wait? Are we ever going to get a Jewel encounter? Set as target. Wait. There's Jewel. Ooh, that's actually pretty cool if we want to wait for 44 years. Oh my, do some Pilates? Are you talking to me? Oh, nice. Good deal. Thanks, Mike. Dude, for all the follows, for your personal follow, I appreciate. For the raid, I appreciate. For all the people that came over and followed, I appreciate. You're freaking awesome. I got you followed. Let me make sure. Yeah, I totally got you followed, Mike. You guys are awesome. Totally awesome. Thank you. Again. If we wanted to wait 44 years, we could get a... What's up, Brain Fried? That's not good. Oh, is that where Jewel is right now? And there is nothing we could do right now. That's in 22 years. Apparently our period is almost 7 years. 7 years. That's the first time we could do the node. Dad, blame it. Alright, what if we start... Ooh, what if we did this? What if we did this? At periaps, what if we came down to Jewel's orbit? Bing. A little bit more. So where is Jewel? Jewel is there. That's not any good. That's not going to do us any good at all. Delta Wing Duck, man, thank you so much. I am totally stoked. Oh, KSPTV just ended. Oh, that may also do it as well. That way it doesn't have the thing. Awesome, Addo. Thank you so much for letting me know. Go for a 15-kilometer flyby of Kerbin. I just read your name again. Yeah, I think it does it every... Wait, I just read your name again? Yeah, it's definitely in there. It's telling me that you followed on October 1st at 31 minutes past midnight. So it may be a little buggy, but it may not have picked you up yesterday. Huh. I don't know. Alright, anyways, that's cool. No worries. That's not going to really get us anywhere. I'm not really too excited about that burn. Stitch this node. I kind of feel like I should just come back to Kerbal so we can get a nice fiery reentry. Should I do that? Because if we know we can get a Kerbin encounter. And that is not going to give us anything. Maybe let's just do some arrow breaking at Kerbin. And see what we get out of that. So right there. Add maneuver. Kerbin's going to be my target. I'm going to take this home and I'm going to freaking try to light it on fire in the sky. Set target. Outstanding. Alright. That's where we are. That's where it's going to be. When is that node? 45 days? Alright, that's a good node. That's a good node. Let's go ahead and bring it on back, boss. Till we see what we can get from Kerbin. In fact, yeah, let's bring it on back. See where Kerbin is. There's Kerbin. Alright, so that's what I said. I gotta wait for longer. I gotta loiter. Yes, and then I gotta get rid of this. Where'd it go? I loiter too much. Loiter less. Sorry for the rocket science. Loiter more. Show me Kerbin. Dang it. I had that Kerbin encounter before. But I just miss. Thus, all of our interstellar Kerbin, if we burn it in the sky, that actually makes sense. Kerbly Quarters. Yeah, y'all got it. That's exactly right. It was like a 500 meter per second burn last time, wasn't it? So less of that. Maybe. Oh, there it is. That's what it was right there. All right, we found it again. And I'm coming in high. I need to go lower. And now I'm coming in how? All right, I need to do a little bit less delta V. Nope, I need to do a little bit more delta V. Nope, I need to fix it with radial in or radial out. Ah, there we go. So close. I'm just trying to get these two things together right here is what I'm doing, y'all. I'm trying to get them the tips to touch, basically. Oh my gosh, I'm so freaking close to that encounter. Look at that. So we're going to be coming in too low. That's right about right. And then let's try this. Nope. Let's try that. Nope. It's only radial in and radial out that's getting it for us. All right. So we need to loiter longer. There it goes. Right there. There we go. Kerbin encounter. Good deal. All right, and I want to do this fast so you guys can actually see something spectacular. Where's Kerbin? There's Kerbin. Focus on Kerbin. We're just playing a orbital ping pong. Orbital pool. I'm trying to get the tips to touch. The baseball game is too unbelievable. Dude, lasting 21. We are doing good, sir. Thank you so much. I do appreciate that. Checking up on me like that. There, wow, what a lousy Kerbin encounter. Let's bring her up into the plane of the orbit. Yes. Excellent. That's closer. And then let's bring it in. I think maybe with something that is less delta V would be good. Nope, that puts us further away. All right, we're still too low, so we need to come up higher. And then let's do this. All right, there we're getting a Kerbin encounter. That's actually going to slingshot us. There's that gravity slingshot. Look at that blind bend. What is that? That is almost straight retrograde to Kerbin, y'all. That would put us in a lower orbit. Oh, no, that puts us in a... That's not retrograde. That's prograde to Kerbin. That we almost could get a solar system escape doing that. Should I just go? Should I just capture my say howdy, y'all? Say howdy, y'all. All right, Mutch. Take it easy. We're just going to capture this one back at Kerbin. Let's go ahead and arrow capture this back at Kerbin, maybe. I don't see a way. Or should I just leave it in orbit? I'm going to F5 it right here. We're going to get a Kerbin arrow capture, which means we go flying through the sky at 3 kilometers per second and completely burn our craft up. And let's see what we can do for that Kerbin arrow capture. Look at that. 343, 346, that's not good. Where's my node even at? I can't even see it. It's behind the sun, I bet you. Oh no, it's behind me. Alright, let's go for this sweet Kerbin arrow capture. Nope, not that. Periaps 2-8. Let's actually just hit Kerbin. That's fine, let's do this burn. 30 minutes. 400 meters per second, so I need to unthrottle up. I need to throttle. Aye, aye, aye. There we go. Cool. What's up, y'all? Check out what we're doing. You just missed the Elu flyby. For everybody in the chat, Yah is the person who skinned the Dr. Pepper can for me. We just did a flyby of Elu. We just left Elu's sphere of influence. Fly into the sun or riot. Solar escape, do it for Delta P. You want me to... I could do a slingshot past Kerbin to see how far out I can get. Then we could, like... burn at the apoaps and get like a completely low solar orbit. That would be awesome. What, Dr. Pepper? So much wind. Yeah, that's our craft. Sorry. That's totally our craft. All right, remember, out here in interplanetary space, we don't really care about the days. Let me just go ahead and add an alarm. Let's get this done fast. I want to do this for everybody that came in. So now I'm time warping. Kerbin, everything is rotating around. We're basically just waiting for the planets to align so that I can do this burn. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, now we're good. Kill that time warp for me. Excellent. Delete on close. Go in. Let's go do this burn. Good thing I was pointing my tail towards the sun. What are we? The surface of what? Orbit. Where is? Why is my node missing? Did I warp past my node? I warped past my node. It didn't quite catch it for us. There's a node. 45 days. Add alarm. Put this one 5 minutes out. Sorry. Now let's get to it. I had to basically reverse time because the game didn't slow me down in time to actually do the burn I needed to do. There's the node coming up. There, we're leaving Elu behind. That's not very fast. Here's the node, and when we get there, we should be good. This is a little bit more precise than we need to burn. Three hours is okay. We can deal with that. So let's find the node. That emergency backup battery again. Good lord. I'm so bad. This craft would be so dead. Where is my node now? There it is. Is this charging the batteries? Yes, it is. Good. All right, I've got solar panels on the bottom. You really enjoying the tan of Dr. Pepper? Warp faster. It's a rookie mistake, and you hate to see it. Oh, my gosh. All right, let's do this node. I don't even know how long it's going to take, but it doesn't matter. Way out here in interplanetary space. Wow, that's terrible. Look at as we shake up the Dr. Pepper can before we release some Dr. Pepper out the bottom of it here. Okay, I think I... Did I get you? I've got your node. I've got your node. Nice, the Atraxi. Did I not follow you on Twitter? Yeah. I don't actually know. Oops, I got a node to burn too. That was a little bit off. Did we get a Kerbin encounter? We did not get a Kerbin encounter. We didn't get anywhere close to a Kerbin encounter. Maybe we need to set Kerbin as the target. Ah, we're close. We're close. I wish you could focus on an encounter. So let's see here. Separation. 182. 188. Alright, so we go in the opposite direction. Point down instead of up. Screet. Alright, and we're charging. That's good. Alright. 765432. There we go. That's what we need to do. There's the Kerbin encounter. Now we'll tweak the approach when we get closer. Let's go to Kerbin and see how we're doing. Alright, if I move up... Okay, that's going to move me under Kerbin. I basically need to go this direction. And that should move me up. Nope. Opposite direction. We don't plan nodes. I'm not planning any nodes. Type DOS to get my attention. There you go. Show us the Dr. Pepper symbol. Okay, good deal. Let me finish this burn correction here. Yeah, you can type DOS and it'll highlight it in red and it makes my screen blink over on this end. Think. There we go. And that's how I know to come check it out, basically. Yes, that's what I want. Move it on in, boss. What if we set the moon as the target? We had a moon encounter! No atmosphere on the moon, though. Alright, that is a Kerbin impact. F5. Let's do this Kerbin impact. Because I can totally land it. Yes, I do. Muddy type DOS. Muddy, show us the Dr. Pepper can so you want to get a screenshot. Alright. There's not really anything around here, though. There's the sun way in the background, but we're a long way from anywhere right now. There you go. How's that? I've actually posted some stuff to Twitter, and I have a couple highlights from our Mooner Dr. Pepper mission. The single Dr. Pepper can will take off from the surface of Kerbin, go out to the moon, basically do a flyby of the moon, and return to Kerbin safely with a powered landing. It must happen. An interstellar fusion plane out of this thing. That's awesome. All right. Did you get your screenshot? I hope you did. I'll do it. Tell me in chat if you didn't. Let me plan another thing here. 3 hours. We don't need that. Add that. We need to do this like 5 minutes out. Look at that. We would go flinging off into interstellar space. I'll set up the trajectory later. Backup battery or bust? You are right, sir. Thank you. I appreciate it. I really appreciate it. Towards the sun. This end. Point this in towards sun. It's like a claymore, but it's a battery. It's a solar panel. All right, now we're charging. Dude, 5 points to you, man. Crispy unibrowdies. Nice. All right, you got the screenshot. Look, even the top of the can is skinned. The top of the can has the Dr. Pepper skin in it. I mean, so cool. Plus, we still have like 4,000 Delta V. 38, 36, jeez. All right, let's go ahead and time warp up here. We're going to be getting closer to the sun. We're basically just crossing the interplanetary distances right now. There's Kerbin. Let's focus on my ship. All right, and we are throwing a freaking ping pong ball that's going to hit another ping pong ball. Actually, we're throwing a grain of sand that's going to hit another ping pong ball in how long? 8 years. That's a lot, actually. It's going to take this a while to happen. Because there's, what, 400 days? 400 something days in a year? And this is the fastest I can time warp it? Yes. on YouTube and TwitBot. Nice. What you got going on there, Chuck House? Let's see here. F5 for great safety. Chuck House, that's awesome. That is totally awesome. Is it a gift? Is it a gift? Does it change? Mud swear jar. Thank you for the follow, sir. Mud swear jar. 400 something. It says GIF. Is it trolling me? Is it not actually a GIF? It's a different universe. Double F5 for great safety. You know what would be interesting? I wonder if the trajectory mod would, somebody... Nice. Yeah, it does. Or it will let you... Gosh. How far now? 7 years. I feel like I need to find something to do. I'm actually out of Dr. Pepper at the house. I just finished the last of it. This is the last of my Dr. Pepper in this cup. We need to make a Dr. Pepper delivery ship that delivers Dr. Pepper. Nice, Tubo. Thanks for coming over, dude. Yes. Oh, let me make sure. That's a good question, Crispy. That is an excellent question. Let's make sure that our emergency backup, that one's enabled. Ooh! Good call. They weren't, one wasn't disabled. Dang. Good call. Actually, this will be our emergency backup battery. We'll put the battery on the probe car as the emergency backup battery. Have two KSP running at the same time. Me? Wait, what? Oh, just saved as a gift to stop the pixel from blinking. Alright, gotcha. Oh my gosh. So we are coming in here. We're going to... How many years do we have? Certainly it's not that many. Oh, is that the... T-minus 271 days? Oh, okay. So that's T-minus 271. Alright, we're coming in. That's cool. Crossing the orbit of Duna. We've already crossed inside Drez. It would be awesome if we could aerobrake it Kerbin just enough to bring our orbit down to Jewel. And then orbit Jewel forever. Yes, you can. When the probe is depowered, you can toggle those. A little bit cheaty. Bounce between games. What? Why would I want to bounce between games? Are you talking to me? Emotes don't work in here, really? Why don't emotes not work in here? Oops, look at that. We orbited the sun enough that we lost that power. Because we lost our pointing at the sun, we orbited enough that the solar panels unpointed around the sun. Good thing you said that, man. Here, check it out. We can totally do this. We can totally, that one's depleted. Luckily, we've got this. I'm not time warped. Now I can point towards the sun. This is why the auto-pointing solar panels are better. Wait, no, point, no, come on. Come on, Dr. Pepper. Point towards the sun. There we go, point towards the sun. Now that's gonna charge our batteries back up. Now we can disable that again. All right. What did I miss? Yeah, I got it, I answered that one, good deal. Excelente. So, I'm just going to go ahead and get a lot closer to Kerbin. Full-time warp action. Here comes our, should I just go straight for the... I kind of want a long arrow break, right? So let me get into Kerbin's Sphere of Influence, and then I will fix this. And I have five out there. And I will go back to that. Because I do want to see how many planets we can get with this. Oh, you can work on something else. I gotcha, Thader. I gotcha. Jeez, that's still days out, isn't it? Alright, slow me down now, boss. There we go, taking that time warp off. X. Now let's go ahead and get past it. 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, 4321, That orbit speed. Yeah, 1,200. Yes, yes. This is about the orbit speed of Kerbin. No, we're coming in hot, y'all. We are coming in way hot. Yeah, I know. That's what I was doing. I didn't want to... That's why I had it down. I had the alarm. I am definitely coming in hot. Our orbit right now is 3353. You know what we should do? We should... Let's see how many G's we can generate with this craft. How many G's can we generate with the Dr. Pepper can? There's Kerbin. We're home, y'all. But all I really want to do... I need to tweak this a little bit. Alright, there's Kerbin. We're coming in low and on the downside right now, right? Yeah. So let's see what we can do to fix this orbit a little bit. Ah, yes. That is bringing me up. That is what I want. Okay, stop. Now we'll go this way. That was inclining me, actually. Let's see. This should bring me up. Nope. Guessed wrong. Now, or I should have known burning north would get me up. Let's see if we can just get a direct impact trajectory for Kerbin. Like that. Now, how much delta V do we have left in the tank? 3,000. I'm going to put another 3,000 delta V into this craft straight at Kerbin. Let's see how many G's we can generate. This is going to be interesting. This is definitely going to be interesting. So let me find my orbit. Not retrograde. We are going to be going insanely fast. We may not even reach terminal velocity. All right. And I got to burn straight down. I basically want that to stay straight there. And we're going to come straight at Kerbin. I kind of feel like I need to burn one way or the other. This way? Nope, that was wrong. This way. Now I've boned it. That's okay. Let's do this. Full throttle, 3,000 delta V straight at Kerbin. That's what I want to do. Let's see how hot we can make this Dr. Pepper can now. Eek. It's a little bit hard. I'll have to save a little bit to modify the trajectory at the end. That is definitely going down towards Kerbin. Alright, 4,000. And as we fall towards Kerbin, we're only going to pick up speed. I'm going to leave 800 in the tank and try for a powered landing. So let's see what we got here. Fling myself out of the galaxy? It won't ever let you escape the sun's sphere of influence. We can do all sorts of stuff with this craft, but for now I'm going to try to do this full on. Alright, maybe I'll save 1,000 meters per second, because that's going to put us north of 6,000 straight down. And that should give me plenty of thrust to land. Look at our thrust to weight. 100,000 100,000 thrust to weight. Oh my gosh. There we go. 1,000 delta V left in the tank. It doesn't even know what's happening. What's going on over there? That maneuver, if I wasn't going to crash into a planet on the way, would definitely fling me out of the galaxy. Not out of the galaxy, really. It would fling me out of the sun's sphere of influence eventually. So, yeah. That is basically... I need to burn... Let me see if I can correct it just a little bit. We're going over 6,000 meters per second towards Kerbin. Alright, opposite direction, because I want to come straight down. Yes. Yes, yes, yes. Yes, yes, yes. Thwip. That there looks good. We're coming straight at Kerbin. Delivering frosty cold interplanetary Dr. Pepper. Honestly, Erky, head for Eve at 1,680 meters per second. Let's see how this works. It's not going to be cold when we get done with this. How's my... All right, now that we've done all of our Bernie McBurnersons... Let's point the tail end towards the planet, or towards the sun, so that we have... What are we going to need solar panels for, honestly? And we are going to... 985 in the tank. Solar panels engaged. Emergency backup battery... set. Alright. Let's get this done. You ever seen Kerbin come up really fast, y'all? I don't think we really need the vessel. I'll get that later. Orbit. That's not really telling us anything either. All right. And actually, I want to Alt F5 and do a reentry. Doctor reentry. So Kerbin, there's the moon, I think. There's Kerbin. That may just be a star back there. Watch my speed go up. There's the moon right there. We're falling straight towards that planet. And that speed is going to start increasing exponentially. The closer we get. It's actually a square. The stage, all stages, yeah. Why is mass two numbers in flight engineer? Why is mass two numbers? Oh, yeah, yeah, you got it. Y'all answered it. This stage and the other stage, yeah. I can't deliver it directly to the launch pad. That's going to be difficult. I could deliver it directly to the launch pad, but not with the ultimate burn-up trajectory here. So, I'm going to watch this G-force meter. So far, the max G-force we've had is 5.4. Let's go ahead and do this. We're coming at 6 kilometers per second. I wonder how fast we can get going. Jeez, we're coming in so fast the Kerbin doesn't have time to act on us. All right, I think maybe we'll break 7 kilometers per second. Look at this dial ticking down. What is our vertical speed? Negative 6.7 kilometers per second. That's fast. That's fast. Quench their thirst with orbital Dr. Pepper. All right, we're about to lose the sun. Oh no, we're going to lose it to the moon first. We're going to have... Are we going to see a lunar eclipse on the way down? Certainly not. What are we going now? 6.8 kilometers per second? Look at that moon! It's gonna set on Kerbin before it hits the sun. Alright. What's the best way to re-enter Dr. Pepper with a logo facing you? Are we gonna reach? We may actually reach 7 kilometers per second. Come on, baby. Uh-oh. Here we go! Bleeding off that speed. 184 Gs. We're gonna hit terminal velocity. Look at that! Oh, we may not. Ah! Too much thrust of weight! I have like ridiculous thrust of weight. I can't. It's like the bouncing Dr. Pepper can. Yeah! Heck yeah, I couldn't see where the ground was. 184 G's at max. The supmosphere throws it down. Oh my gosh. It wants the terminal D. Cadaverific. He's nuking the planet with Dr. Pepper. We totally landed at Trescu with a good job, dude. Thank you, sir. I want to tuck it in. Nice. Alt F9. Reload it and do what? Don't open that can. How much fuel did I have left over? I had 500. Look, I could probably take back off again if I could lean up. If I was at a mountain, I could totally take off again. Let's see. Here we go. Off the hill. No! So close. How did I manage to stop it? It opened a hole in the ozone layer. We can do it a different way. All right, I'll land it at KSC. I will land it at KSC for you, and then I'm going to call the stream. We'll go raid somebody. I will land it at KSC, even though we're coming in at this crazy orbital velocity. I think I can do that. Alt F9. Dr. Reentry. 184 G's. That's ridiculous. My Dr. Pepper. What just happened? It just blew up in space. What the? When I reloaded the save file, the Dr. Pepper blew up. The Dr. Pepper blew up. Dude, K9, thank you, sir, for hanging out. Thank you very much for hanging out. You are always a regular, dude. I totally appreciate you, man. Always. Why did it just blow up in space? And I can't zoom in on it or anything. Look. It's like everything blew up except for these parts. We have a taper. We have a sweet... I shook it too much. I was going too fast and the Kraken killed it. Eek. Is it going to blow up again? Whew! It lived that time. Why did it just miscellaneously blow up the first time? Handman, take it easy, sir. Thank you so much. We will... Let's get this done. How much... I need a certain amount of Delta V to do this. All right. So I'm going to have to go into an orbit. So let's do... Nope, not switch to. I just want to set... No. Asparagus. Stager. No. Not you. Here, hide everything. Just Kerbin, please. No. Also not that. Kerbin, please. Not Nimbus either. Kerbin. Oh, I can't set it as a target. Never mind. I can focus the view on it, though. There's the sun, there's Moho, Eve, Gilly, Kerbin. Alright. So I'm coming in like freaking crazy. The game was upset. Poison Gold, thank you for hanging out. As always, you sleep as well. Too much awesome contained in one. Alright. All I need to do, I am going to actually have to... This is 90 degrees. If I'm coming straight down, which way is this going to put me? Yes, that is the way that I can go. And that is going to put me in the correct orbit. All right, good. How much Delta V is this going to cost me? Probably not very much. I just need to get a Kerbin Periaps. And we're going to have to bleed off 6 kilometers per second of orbital velocity with the atmosphere. Alright, so see, I'm going to go through the atmosphere like this. Do you think I can do it? I can certainly bleed off 6 kilometers per second. Alright, there we have a Periaps. Trajectory mode activate. Wow, it has no clue. We're coming in too hot. It cannot calculate our trajectory. Oh no, it says we're landing. Look, it says we're landing. Okay. What part of the planet are we hitting? Right there. Okay, that's not going to help us. That's not what we want at all. I need to burn north a little bit. That's south. I need to burn north a little bit to bring this up to the north. Not exactly how it works, but the situation we're in right now, it works. That right there is what I want. Because I know that that's about Kerbal Space. Alright, now we need to give it more... Up. No, incorrect. We need to give it more 90 degrees. Wasn't it 90 degrees? Yeah, give it more east. Basically. How am I doing on my engine, my vessel? Alright, trajectories, you're good. Thank you. Vessel, 923. Alright, as long as I got like 500 in the tank, I can land it. Okay, there is a freaking arrow capture. That is a good looking arrow capture. I want it to be less, though. I want to go into a good orbit. I need to throttle down my engine so I can do this accurately. Also, panel lock. Alright, we're good. Let me throttle down this engine because I need some accuracy. And let's do this. Dang it. Well, where's that have me hitting? Oh, it doesn't have any clue what's going to happen. It can't calculate it. It can't calculate it. I need enhanced nav ball. Blah, 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 blah. This says this actually looks really good. I don't know why it can't calculate this, but let's go with it, right? Because that looks like a very nice orbit. And we are just going to... Look at us arrow breaking through Kerbin. Have you ever seen an arrow break do a button hook like that? We'll see how accurate this mod is. I think I'm good. I think I'm going to be happy with that. So let's go Alt-F5. Arrow break. This is Dr. Arrow break. Dr. Arrow capture, really. And that engine is throttled down. I got to remember that. I could actually land with like 50% throttle, but... I gotta remember that. Okay, that's taken care of. Tail towards the sun for the solar panelage. And let's see if we can't get this thing down at KSC. Too fast for the mod coder to calculate. Go higher just a bit? Wait, why, Luis? I think we're good. What do I make do with? Just crash into the spaceport. There's no necessary. There's no way to know that it, where I'm going to be hitting. I was nowhere near the spaceport that time. So let's see here. I need to. Let's just go down. Zooming up towards Kerbin. There's the moon. There's Kerbin. And when we get down there, I am going to point straight program. We're going to heat up the top of that can. All right, here we go. Here we go. Are we good? That says we're still good. Luis, I don't know what you saw. Land on the launch pad. We shall see. I don't know what that is. I feel like that, and then we're going to be going back down right there. Let's go through this arrow break and see what we got. We're going to go straight. Oops, that's upside down. Where's the sun? That's okay. We're coming in too hot to need that solar the solar batteries anymore. To need the battery juice. We wouldn't be able to burn through that battery power in the time that this is going to happen in. Electric charge, 99, electric charge. All right. So here we go. We're going to be missing it to the side this time, right? Because I want to aero break in the atmosphere. Check this out. Hold my Dr. Pepper. Yeah, we're good. We're good. A little bit faster. And here we go into the atmosphere. We're coming up hot on it. We do have a periaps in the atmosphere at 24. Have you ever aerobraked at Kerbin at 24 kilometers? I got this. Hold my Dr. Pepper. I don't know how to pronounce that, but welcome to the channel. We're about to do a serious freaking aero break using a Dr. Pepper can at Kerbin. We already took this Dr. Pepper can out to Elu. We started with a six pack on the launch pad, and this craft had 6,400 meters per second of Delta V. We took it out to Elu. We wasted 3,500 Delta V accelerating towards Kerbin so that we could be going 7 kilometers per second when we re-entered. Good times. Good times. Because you're not a Kerbal murderer. There are no Kerbals in this. There's totally no Kerbals in this. We should just turn off SAS. And see how this re-enters. We're already in the atmosphere. We're starting to burn up. Watch those G's. Where's our G's? Where's our G meter? Wow, we're actually doing a real re-entry this time. T. Look at that thing. We're freaking slowing the heck down. It's Kerbin that orbit. We would still escape Kerbin. We would look at us. What? Now it thinks we're gonna land. This mod. It totally thinks that we're going to land because we're so deep in the atmosphere. Is it wrong? Aim skyward, buddy. I'm still doing this to the Supmosphere. No Kerbal in the can, but the shockwave will blow some roofs off down there. We're still aero braking. We're totally still aero braking, but I had to save it. I totally had to save it and get back up out of the atmosphere. I don't even know where my craft is. Let's turn it on. Isn't it a probe? Yes. No. Backspace. There you go. Hopefully this gets us out of the atmosphere. We are going up. I did have to burn some Delta V, but we're okay. You believe in the mod. It definitely told me that I was coming down. I probably could have just left it, but look at that! We're almost at the Kerbal Space Center! That's almost exactly what I needed to do. Watch. Watch. Young Padawan. We are almost at the Space Center. Look at that. I'm in the atmosphere. I'm going to do my correction burns in the atmosphere. I should probably come out of the atmosphere first. How about that? That was just field expedient, right? We're coming back up out. All right, we're at 50, so we're not going to slow down much. Look at that. Look at that. That is so freaking cool. That's what the crosshair is. Me, I'm a lucky SOB, dude. You know it. You know it. You know how lucky I am. I totally meant to. I told you to hold my Dr. Pepper. I totally meant to do that. It's going to be almost exactly right. Look at this. I'm just going to need a little bit of a northward tweak, and we should be good to go. We should be totally good to go, y'all. Totally meant to do that. Alright, once I get up in the oven, just tuck it in. What? Alright, wait. Now that we're here, I can point retrograde. How am I on power? I'm good. I'm actually in the sun. Alright, let's do this, y'all. Let's go. Ding! And then we need to go north. We need to go north. Horizontal north. We're just zooming in. That's, for anybody who doesn't know Kerbal Space Program, that little place right there is the space center. It's the clear bit of land. All right. Ding! That right there is probably pretty darn close. I should have somebody run out to the runway and stand on the runway as a beacon. But that right there is going to be pretty close. I love it. You don't run this cheat mod. This should be stock. Not even going to lie. Alright, so if I point retrograde and I put myself can first. Let's go ahead and do this reentry, y'all. I'm already back in the atmosphere again. Like, I just barely went out there, like, barely, like 71. 71K is where I went. Yeah, I didn't install it. I do need the probe beacons, you are correct. I didn't install Enhanced Navball because it's coming out in 0.25, so I just didn't add it to the mod list. Here comes Dr. Pepper. How many G's, by the way? G-Force, only 16. That was actually still freaking deadly reentry. Would have kicked our asses, honestly, with that whole shenanigan. Vessel display, I don't need orbit. Well, tell me the thrust of weight. This is the Space Center right here. If you landed on the VAB again, you're going to sleep. They said the launch pad. I don't know. I don't have a lot of Delta V, and I'm coming in a little bit to the side. Now I'm coming in too far the other way. Alright, let's do that. I'm coming in short, it feels like. Yeah, I'm coming in short. I don't know if I have enough Delta V to land it on the launch pad. Because I didn't have the beacons here this time, right? Alright, 270-90. What I need to do is burn it this way. I can't fly it very far at all. Let's see what we got. 270, jeez. I try a suicide burn. Yeesh. I needed a little burst and quench the thirst. That's weird. What's happening? Oh no, I can't fly far enough. I'll put 100 more into it, but yeah, we're gonna keep flying. I can crash it into the VAB. I don't even have enough now. I don't even have enough to kill my velocity. Suicide burn. No! 34! So close! So close! So close! Dr. Pepper delivery failure! Oh my gosh. Tazaret, I guess you can go ahead. We didn't have enough. I wasted all the Delta V on that whole thing, and we didn't quite have enough. We didn't quite have enough. I'm not embarrassed, though. I am not embarrassed. I was trying for the suicide burn, and I didn't have enough Delta V left. Very close. I mean, what do we have? 16.7G? Yeah. Oh my gosh. I almost want to play around with that one more time. I can't end on a crash like that. I can't end on a crash. I really can't end on a crash. No, I didn't put shoots on this. We went to Elu. We didn't carry shoots to Elu and back. I can't end on a crash. I can't end on a crash. I just can't do it. If y'all want to stay around, you made it to Minimus tonight during the stream. Nice! If y'all want to stay around, there's Dr. Aerobrake again. We need a little bit more because I wasted a lot of Delta V fixing that, You know something? We're going to get this done. Focus on Kerbin. 1, 2, Moho, Eve, Gilly, Kerbin. There we go. Alright, and we needed to go a little bit higher. Right? Which would be radial out. Which would be east, in this case. Just a little tiny bit, though. 25. Jeez, that's sensitive. I don't want that much. I need to bleed off some more. Alright. That right there, could I do that right there? And when I'm still in the atmosphere, could I give it a little bit of a tweak? Yes. Alright. This is Dr. Pepper. Quick, set your probes after adjust. Yes, yes, yes. Oh, you're right, you're right. Set my probes after adjust. Periaps is in 3 hours. All right, that's time for somebody to run out the runway and hold up some. Dazarn, take it easy. Thank you for hanging out, sir. Yeah, Luis did say a little bit higher. No, he's right. I'm not going to say he was wrong. Let me do this. That's with the 13.5 thrust limiter? That looks pretty good, doesn't it? Do we think that looks pretty good? That's more of a curlicue sort of deal. Quick, set your thrusters to quenched. What? What? Alright, is that charging? No. Then we'll run out. We'll have a dude stand on the launch pad and we'll try to hit him. Not sun either. There we go. That's pointing towards the sun. All right. Now, quick, back to the Space Center. I had full thrust on that landing. Did I have full thrust? I think I did. This looks good. All right. Good, Luis. Let's see. Dude, that's a nutty station. Dave, that's actually really cool. All right. This looks good, he says. What can we do? On the launch pad, should we try for the launch pad? Yes. We should make a Dr. Pepper basket with ice cubes in it or something. Ain't nobody got time for that. We'll put this little hut on the runway, and we will just launch it, right? Once you start aerobraking, it will recalculate anyways. Okay, good. That sounds good. And I did have full thrust on that landing. Okay, good. Because I think I busted all the Delta V. You know, when I did the part mod, by the way, anybody that wants the Dr. Pepper GAN, you can have it. There's the mod. Right there. Make it a 5-pack and land it to a 6. Are you nuts? What do you think I am? I'm going to have Jeb out here to wave it in. Waiting for his Dr. Pepper. It should be coming in from this direction, right? And this thing, can I rename it? No, I can't. I have to set it to a base, actually. If I don't set it to a base, it won't appear correctly. Grab it, board it, rename vessel. Doctor delivery target. Set it as a base. That makes it appear from a little bit further out, actually. EVA. All right, Jeb. I wish you could stand on top of your pod and wait for it. I don't think he can make it up there, though, can he? Yeah, he can't make it up there. He's just going to stand right here and wait for this thing to come in. That looks good. RCS. Just standing there waiting. Very patient. Alright. Back to the Space Center, because I gotta go to the thing. Or I could have pressed M and did switch to, I guess. Alright, dang it. Ja! Did you... Ja 2369. Okay. Hack gravity, fly on top. No. Land a 12-pack. Yeah, I will definitely hit you up, man. Let me actually make a copy of this right quick. I'm just going to paste it in my notepad so that I remember to do it. There we go. He's going to get squished. Base name, Quickie Mart. Alright, let's go to the Dr. Pepper. I gotta land this thing on the freaking launch pad with the mod. Now that we have that, let's see what we got. Okay, that's good, that's good. Then let's go out to the doctor on escape trajectory out of Kerbin. Mission elapsed time 8 years. Jeb has been waiting patiently for 8 years. He's so thirsty. Dr. Pepper's can from deep space. All right, here we go. And I'll give it another Alt F4. There is Kerbin. How are we on electric power? Good to go. Good to go. I really need to know which way is dorsal on this craft. All right. There's the sun off to our right. Let's get this done, y'all. From the 6-kilometer orbit. A little bit faster. Excuse me. Here's Kerbin. Alt-5. Here's Kerbin. There we go. Save. All right. Let's get this done. Coming in hot. 65 this time. 68, 69, 55. All right. Point prograde for me, Dr. Pepper. There it is. Straight prograde. Wouldn't want those solar panels to get hurt. Print that screen. Totally printing that screen. Print screen. I'm like a photographer. Yeah, work it. Work it, Dr. Pepper. Work it for me. Oh, yeah. Maybe we should actually watch what's going on. All right, we're not captured yet. It'd be really hilarious to see if we got any encounters with other planets. All right, that's Kerbin right there. It says I'm gonna land again. Should we just let it go and see if this is accurate or not? It definitely looks like it's accurate, doesn't it? So it is not accurate when coming in at a... Yeah, it's not accurate. Now, that was even too deep, yo. Well, forget it. Let's do it that way. Although, look, it's not accurate. See? We're gonna have to put it out past Kerbin. Out past the Space Center, I mean. Alright, we're just gonna watch it, okay? Snuggly Squid, I saw it right now. Take it easy, sir. Thank you for always hanging out. You are a regular, and I do appreciate you. I totally appreciate you. The tasty. Yeah, Thader, I got it. That was what was going on. Nicely chilled. Just don't put your tongue on the can. All right, I'm feeling good about this. I'm feeling good about this one. I have to go higher than that? Just now? It still rotates in your cheat lander program. What? Where is it at? Come on now. Alright, so once I get into orbit up to my Apo, I'll fine-tune that. That's the trick right there, getting as much zoom as possible, because both those things are All right. I think right now I can do it right. What's my altitude? 7.5? Yeah, we're good. All right. I need one more level of zoom. Dang it. All right. We're okay. Junior Braves, 37. Welcome to Kerbal Space Academy. I'm playing around. My name is Das. I do Kerbal Space Academy. A lot of times I do, every evening I will actually do... I'll actually do Kerbal Space Academy where we cover a specific topic. We are playing around right now. We just aerobraked a Dr. Pepper can from 6 kilometers per second. Apparently, how much G's did we generate that time? How many G's? 16 G's, so not so bad. Not so bad that time. Drag middle mouse. Oh, will that work from over there? It won't work from the orbital view. Or from the map mode. But I think I'm good. I think I've got it right there. So let's see. Let's go ahead and warp through this part. Actually. Coming in for a pepper. Alright, and then we will... time warp till we re-enter the atmosphere. Alrighty, then we'll keep a point of prograde. We are upside down. Our Dr. Pepper can is upside down. That's not good. There we go. This is going to be hard. That side with the strut up, that's the dorsal side with the strut on it. Okay. Yeah, worth a shot. Yeah, definitely worth a shot. Alright, orbital Dr. Pepper can. Let's get down there. We don't want to spend a lot of time on this, right? They don't die. They can take infinite G's. an impact velocity, but they can take infinite G's. Is that like a knock-knock joke? This is looking good. Stay on target. Stay on target. Stay on target. Coming in a little bit short now that I've zoomed in that far. Coming in just a little bit short. You'll see that? There we go. Alright. That said it was good, right? Yeah, that says we're right freaking on it. We're coming for you, Jeb. It would be awesome if I could switch and see it from Jeb's perspective. Alright, go ahead and get me on down there, girly. I'm coming in a little bit to the left, it feels like, doesn't it? Maybe not. Trust your instincts. Stay on target. Stay on target. Does it look like I'm coming in short? Now it looks like I'm coming in short! No! Not cool! Not the same thing. Not like this. Alright, I'll give it 100 meters per second of flying. I'll start with 50. And see if that does it. Eek! 86 meters per second left in the tank. That's not enough. Wow! We'll see what we can do. I can't zoom in anymore, so that is all the, That sucks, only 82 meters per second. Jeb, no, you're Dr. Pepper can, buddy! Oh, yay, yay! Oh! Wait! Wait! Oh my goodness, y'all. Jeb, I'll deliver this Dr. Pepper if it's the last thing I do. The bad news is that we don't have solar power, but we've got the emergency battery. And it's definitely not. We lost the engine. The only thing I lost from that suicide burn was the engine. Oh no, but I can't turn. Jeb. No, Jeb. I hope this doesn't clip and get us stuck. Run, Jeb. I'm not done. I'm not done. I'm not giving up yet. I'm not giving up on delivering this to the launch pad. No. Grr, freaking four-wheel drive, Dr. Pepper can. Yes. Turn me. Turn me. All right, all right. Yeah. Yes. That time warp, though. All right. We rolled. I have to be able to turn somehow. Oh, my gosh. I can't. Except for... No, that turned the wrong way! Am I out of electric charge? No. I have plenty of electric charge. Why have I stopped being able to turn? What the deuce? Roof. Alright, alright, alright. Here we go. Back in action. No! It was so good and now I'm stuck in the trough! Blame it. This is lame. Okay. I need to figure out the rotational period of it. Nope, it's stuck again. Apparently sometimes it gets confused. Alright. So this way, for half a turn... For half a turn, that's doing nothing. Is there fuel left in this? Nope, I burned all of that fuel. This is so lame. Oh, what was that? Oh, oh! Totally figured it out. Apparently, I think I torqued myself up just enough that I could rotate. Jeb, your Dr. Pepper's coming, buddy. Your Dr. Pepper is coming. Don't give up. Let's turn off Kerbal Engineer. I'm going to deliver this Dr. Pepper to the launch pad. I haven't even read chat yet. Oh, my goodness. 277 meters from deliciousness. You know what would be awesome? Chase view. Chase view. Or this should have been one of those Kumbo thingies. Uh oh, trouble. Which way's the launch pad? Okay, good. All right. There we go. I figured out how to turn it. It's apparently not on that angle. Oh, time warp is on. When it lands, there's something that it's landing on that keeps it from going. I'm not going to be able to roll up the cliff, am I? That time warp got me stuck again. Alright, this is apparently not the right place to be doing this. Yeah. We've got to roll out of it. There we go. You just got to find the right key combination. Alright, we're good. Does this count? Tell me this counts. This probe went to Elu, y'all. I don't know how I turned it so well that first time. Oh, well, let's just keep rolling. There we go. Maybe when I get on the edge of this polygon, I can, That's interesting. Okay. Well, roll the other way then. Whatever. Look at the probe core moving. Aha! Got it. I haven't even checked the chat, y'all. I need to check the chat. Look at the probe core torquing itself. Oh, it wants to go! It wants to go! There we go. Excellent. Other direction. Oh, that's it right there. That's what we need to do. There we go. I need, like, Rocky music. Jebediah! It's rolling a little crooked, as it turns out. I can't click on the chat window because I can't hold down the Kerbal Space Program button and click on the chat window at the same time. Oh no, I don't think we're gonna be able to go up that slope, do y'all? We've barely used any electric charge. And there is a clipping thing on that, isn't there? Yeah, there is. I am dedicated to this mission. I mean, Hot Gaming drove a rover to the North Pole. I am dedicated to delivering this Dr. Pepper can. There we go. Yeah! Four-wheel drive, baby! Oh, no. Oh, no. No. No, don't tell me you won't go past those parts. Oh, wait, time warp off. Yeah! Am I hitting that? Get there! Apply that torque, baby! Come on, there's a weird... Oh, I see what's happening. What if I, like, broke my probe core off right now? There we go. All right. Apply that torque. Roll it up the hill. Jeb. From Jeb's perspective. We'll film this from Jeb's perspective. I have too much fun doing this, y'all. This should probably be illegal. I feel like I'm picking up speed, actually. I want to be here with Jeb whenever the DP crests. Oh! There it is! Wait, F2. print screen. It's coming! I gotta get it with the delicious Dr. Pepper logo facing this way. Print screen. No, don't get stuck. Yeah! This is like very much can-do 80s music. Print screen. Look at them screenshots, yo. That side's ugly. What are the chances? I can't wait to read chat, by the way. We're up on top now, apparently. Screen. That's a good screenshot right there, I think, right? Hello, Jeb. Pleased to meet you. Turn. Have some delicious Dr. Pepper. What? Don't you want some? Don't you want to drink some Dr. Pepper? I can't. Oh, man, I wanted. All right. I think this is a successful mission. I was going to try and pour some in his mouth, but I don't even have a way to open the top of the can. So that's close enough. We pushed Jeb with a Dr. Pepper can. Let me read chat. A six-pack with a birthday cake. I've been waiting. What's the mission? I've been waiting 8 years, 234 days, 2 hours, 57 minutes, and 13 seconds for this drink. But the can is empty. Oh my gosh. Dr. Pepper can rolling down the runway. Use the nav ball. Oh, I see what you're saying. Yeah. Where was this at? Drag mouse. Okay, let's see what we said. Eye of the tiger. And you have 300 Delta V. In before the fireball. RIP Jeb, no rotation. No, the mod takes it into rotation. Go! Just don't open it for a while. Slightly dented can of refreshing goodness. We're rolling it. I was surprised. I didn't think it was going to make it uphill. You can turn. You just have to yaw while you're rolling around. Yeah. Make a rover with a claw. How do you spiel with a paddle boat? 99 Dr. Peppers on the trough. Oh my gosh. You'll be blown to the moon. Stop. Oh my goodness. My octo strut needs to be down. Yeah, I wasn't thinking about it too much. For science, you monster. Oh, jeez. Oh, I'm still reading. Six pack with a birthday cake. Fall asleep, it's 2 a.m. I don't know how to help you there, sorry. Sorry, wasn't that Tesla. Sorry, wasn't 30 minutes or less. Oh, jeez. Alright, y'all. A trip around Elu. The Dr. Pepper has been delivered to Jeb here at the launch pad. That's that. Where's Jeb at? Yes. Let me get him over here. Oh, I'm so hungry. I'm so thirsty. I need to drink this. He's like freaking. There we go. How is that? Jeb, smile for the camera. Come on. Do something that makes you happy. Why are you so freaking straight-faced, Jeb? That's not it. He's not smiling. He's kind of getting on my nerves a little bit. Smile, Jeb. Ah, dude, Rabata. Thank you, sir, for hanging out. Everybody hanging out is so freaking awesome. Deep space roasted cola. I think it's about time. With this scene, y'all, with this scene, it's about time to shut this stream down. Because I think we're good. You know how we do, though. We don't just shut down the stream. We try to go places and do things. His head looks like a... Ooh. You're right. I've never noticed that, Chalkhouse. His head does look like the can tab. Let's see who's going. Let's go find somebody to raid if you want to. Let's see. Yeah. Muddy, do we know anybody, buddy? You guys brought in two raids. I feel like I should return the favor. Nice, Adel. Take it easy. The refueler? Skin a hitchhiker module. Steelmage, do you mean the big, the Epic 6 orbital refueler? Where are we going for the raid? I'm definitely going to send the screenshot to Dr. Pepper. That'll be awesome, honestly. Let's see here. I don't know what save that's in. If you can hang out, let's get the raid going, Steelmage, and then we will, I'll see if I can find that for you, okay? It's also, if you're looking for the Epic 6, it's up on Kerbal X. There's a bunch of screenshots of it up on that, if that's what you want. So, let's get the raid going. Let's find somebody to raid. On to Zin. We shall go raid. And the coolest way to raid. KSPTV? Nope, that's from a while ago. That's because it shut down. The white ship? Yeah, the Epic 6 Fueler. Yeah. Megna Gaming. Overload's playing. Ranger Boy. T Davenport, North Star, T Bird. Lobster's playing. Lol Rager. I don't see. Nobody. There's Overload, Earthworm. Wait! Oh no! Is he on right now? If Earthworm's on, we're definitely raiding Earthworm. We're definitely raiding Earthworm Slim. If he is on right now. Let me check. Yes. Yes. Oh, so we're gonna do a bit of a Tanuki's on too? What is Tanuki playing? Oh, she's playing Fear. Guys, Earthworm Slim gives me so much freaking support. Absolutely, Earthworm gives me so much freaking support. Let's do this. Let's do a multi-raid. We can go to Tanuki, we can go to Earthworm, we can go to Overload, we can go to all of those places. We're going to start with Earthworm, though, because he gives me so much freaking support. He's so freaking cool. And let's go over there. I'm going to get his... Let's see here. Let me actually go to it. Earthworm Slim. What you should do when I post the link up, right-click on it and do open in a new tab. That way you'll still be able to hear me talking, but we can go over there when you get to Earthworm. What do you say? You say, Das Raid... That's how you do it. We got it. We got to support Slim. Slim is over here all the time. He's such a good guy. I mean, we're going to go support Slim first off. And then if you stay in this channel, right-click, open a new stream, right-click, open a new stream sort of deal. We can do a multi-raid. We can go see Tanuki. We can go to Overload if we want. We can go all over. We should raid Man versus Game. That would be hilarious. Here's where we're going first, though. Full support for my underground buddy, Earthworm Slim. Oh, that's okay, Crazed. Whatever you need to do. This is Earthworm. We're going there first. Just go over there. Toss him a DOS raid. We'll come back. We'll see Tanuki as well. You can stay on whatever stream you want. You can choose what you want to watch. But let's go make Earthworm feel good. That's where we're going. Over to Earthworm Slim. Let's see if we can't cause some ruckus in his channel. I'm not going to be the first one to do it. Oh, Tanuki just ended. Dad, blame it. That's okay. We'll go see Overload. We'll go say hi to Overload. There you go. Yeehaw! Hootin' and hollering. Enable Rage. Hootin' and hollering. DOS Raid. PJ Almighty got over there. Swords there. Steel Mage. Dave's there. Who else is over there? Tesla Matt came. Tresh came. K McNeil came. Wait. No, K McNeil just said my name. Never mind. And we'll go see Overload next, y'all. Crispy Brownies is coming in. I gotta turn him on, actually. There he is. Now I can hear him, too.
Sword, welcome back, buddy. How's it going?
Heck yeah. So cool.
Doss Valdez, none other than himself. And there's a bunch of trolls coming up in here. What's up, Tesla Max? Oh, jeez, Louise.
See if we can make him crash. If you can still hear the sound of my mouth, you should totally toss Slim a follow, because he's cool. Luis Piloto, thank you, sir, as always, for hanging out, man. Ruckus in the truckus. Thader comes over with the DOS raid.
I want you, the viewers, to tell me how his stream was, okay? Give me the drove a six-pack. Oh my god.
That's not good. Slam on the brakes. He's in a huge wreck. Oh my gosh. Guys, if you like fun streamers. He is a fun streamer, y'all. He is definitely. The stream wrote a Dr. Pepper can to everywhere. That guy just crashed. That was a perfect time. They're going to have to call for wreckers or something. Nuke them from orbit.
We got ourselves a convoy there, didn't we?
Needs more claw.
Thank you for that follow, mister. It means a lot to me.
All right, let's go see Overload 2. You can stay on whatever stream you want. The right-click open a new tab thing is totally cool. If you can still hear the sound of my voice, I am going to... Let's go to Overload as well. Oh, yeah. Let's see how much support we can bring over to Overload's channel as well. Totally up to you what you want to watch. There's Overload, y'all. If you can, right-click. Ooh, I gotta mute him. Let's see if anybody else goes over to Overloads. I'm actually going to start it. Don't leave me hanging, guys. Don't leave me hanging. Where is that? There's that. All right. So awesome.
You ruined the tasty truck of Dr. P. The tasty truck? What's the tasty truck?
Dude, so much fun. Shockhouse, man. Thanks for hanging out. A lot of fun. A lot of fun. You guys are so cool for doing the multi-raid. That's so freaking cool. Got quite a few. See if he refuses.
Oh, we're going too fast. Nope. That's what happens when you ascend in Time Warp.
What just happened? Did he crash? Did Overload? Hey, nice. Perfect timing with Overload.
Oh, wait, might still work. There we go. And we have orbit height.
You guys are so cool. So cool.
There we go. Look at that. Totally yeah, worked.
I know. That's why all I was right, like.
And then fairings.
Yeah, Dylan's gamer tag. We just raided some totally people. If you want to watch some Kerbal Space Program, go over to our buddy Overload UT's channel, which is this right here. It just scrolled through chat.
But here we go. Once we're up this high, I wanted to see if that
I am right there. And if you go over there, toss him a DOS raid. Tell him you came from DOS like that. Good deals.
Really not.
Is this Kerbal going to die?
No.
Cuz he's super hardcore.
Oh, even with RCS.
Trish, dude. Can barely kill. Thank you. A lot of fun, y'all. Enough. A lot of fun.
It's enough. It just takes a while to turn. And obviously we can throttle up.
The Dr. Pepper Snapple group. Values okay, philanthropy. Da. Really?
Detach there.
Let's see.
Use the atomic. Go wherever we want.
Really?
Da-da-da-da-da. Have to manually stage separate the last
environmental
one.
Charitable donation.
Use these guys. Have all the RCS that we could ever want.
Isn't it awesome?
Forever. Turn off SAS.
It's so cool. I don't think Overload even noticed that we came in. He's, like, very focused.
And then Physics Warp.
For sponsorship. Dude, everybody, you guys are all awesome. I'm going to go ahead and shut down my stream now. If you want to watch Overload, go for it. I'm going to go hang out with Slims for a while. Talk to him. Everything's cool. I had so much fun. We'll be back tomorrow. What did I say we were doing? I said tomorrow we're doing space stations. So we'll do space stations mañana.
Go.
And on that note.
Go back to one.
We will go ahead and shut down the stream. You don't have to go home. You know what I always say every night. But you could stay here if you wanted to, whatever. Everybody.